Hello students, this is Saili Patil. Welcome to the current affairs session conducted by Target Government Jobs. In previous session, we discussed some important questions on Indian affairs. Today we are going to discuss next 50 questions on the same topic. These questions, these current affairs are completely based on month July and for year 2019. And even I want you all to take the notes of important topics I'm going to discuss. So let's start with the first question. Which scheme was announced in the budget to consolidate 125,000 km road length in the states which connect habitations and to be implemented for the period from 2019-20 to 2024-25? And the given options are Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bhima Yojana 3, Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana 3, Pradhan Mantri Gramin Avas Yojana 3, Pradhan Mantri Avas Yojana 3, and none of this. So what do you think, what will be the answer? So students, यहाँ पे पूछा गया है कि अलग अलग स्टेट्स में जो रेसिडेंसेस है उनको जो रोड कनेक्ट करता है इट हैज़ अ लेंथ ऑफ 125,000 किलोमीटर और उसको कंसोलिडेट करने के लिए मतलब मजबूत बनाने के लिए एक बजट अनाउंस किया गया था तो वो कौन से स्कीम के अंडर लॉन्च किया गया था ये पूछा है सो भीमा योजना सड़क योजना आवास योजना या फिर प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना सो इसका जो राइट आंसर है इट इज प्रधानमंत्री ग्राम सड़क योजना ओके एंड ये जो स्कीम है PMGSY3 ये स्कीम अनाउंस की गई थी 2018-19 के बजट स्पीच में ओके 2018-19 का जो बजट स्पीच हुआ था उसमें ये स्कीम लॉन्च की गई थी ओके सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन Which ministry has formed 10-member inter-ministerial committee to assess the various aspects of enacting central law against attack on duty doctors and medical establishments? So what can be the answer? Basically this question means ki a law was made against attack on duty of doctors and medical establishments and for that a 10-member inter-ministerial committee was formed. So, ये जो committee form की गई थी वो कौन से ministry ने form की गई थी ऐसे पूछा है. So, Ministry of Human Resource Devil, Ministry of Women and Child Development, Ministry of Home Affairs, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare या none of these. So, the right answer for this is Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Basically, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, it is an Indian government ministry and it is also responsible for all government programs relating to basically family planning in India. Okay, so Ministry of Health and Family Welfare is responsible for family planning in India. So let's see the next question. Along which border government has approved phase 1 of भारतमाला परियोजना विद द फाइनेंशियल आउटले ऑफ रुपीज़ 5,30,000 CR टू डेवलप 24,800 किलोमीटर हाईवेज सो स्टूडेंट्स दिस भारतमाला परियोजना दिस इज बेसिकली स्पॉन्सर्ड एंड फंडेड रोड एंड हाईवेज प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड इट इज़ लॉन्च्ड by our Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi to connect various highways from like Gujarat, Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, Jammu and Kashmir, etc. and etc. So basically यहाँ पे पूछा गया है कि कौन से border पे government ने phase 1 के लिए approve किया था भारतमाला परियोजना के phase 1 के लिए approve किया था So the right answer of this is Indo-Nepal border Okay बेसिकली हमारे जो यूनियन मिनिस्टर है फॉर रोड ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड हाईवेज़ के यूनियन मिनिस्टर श्री नितिन गडकरी इन्होंने 8 जुलाई 8 July 2019 को राज्यसभा में ऐसा मेंशन किया था दैट इंडो नेपाल बॉर्डर का फर्स्ट फेज जो है दैट इज ओपन्ड. ओके एंड इट इज आउटलेड ऑफ रुपीज 5,35,000 CR एंड इट इज गोइंग टू डेवलप्ड हाईवे ऑफ 24,800 किलोमीटर. ओके सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट वन. Name the group which was banned by Union Cabinet under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act 1967. So the answer of this is Sikhs for Justice. Okay, so students, do you know what is Sikhs for Justice? It is basically a US based NGO. Okay, yeah, it is a NGO, and the founder of this NGO is Guru Patwant Singh Pannun. Guru Patwant Singh Pannun. Okay, and it is a US based NGO. It is basically, it supports and campaigns for the Sikhs in Punjab. Okay, so let's see the next one. Which country has adequate number of healthcare professionals as per research conducted by the Indian Institute of Public Health, IIPH, Gurugram? Okay, so they have given us different countries in options like India, Japan, China, United States or none of these. So, kaun si country ne healthcare professionals basically अच्छे खासे दिए हैं, यू नो बेसिकली टू प्रोवाइड हेल्थ केयर सर्विसेज टू रूरल एंड अर्बन एरियाज. ओके सो इंडिया जो है, मतलब हमारी कंट्री ने ही एडिक्वेट नंबर ऑफ हेल्थ केयर प्रोफेशनल्स दिए हैं. बेसिकली इट इज़, यू कैन क्रैक दिस लॉजिकली ऑल्सो, इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ IIPH गुरुग्राम है, सो इंडिया ही होगा, राइट? सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट वन. एक्सपांड ASEAN. यहाँ पे हमें ASEAN का फुल फॉर्म पूछा है. ओके सो गाइज, डू यू नो वॉट इज ASEAN? सो ASEAN मीन्स एसोसिएशन ऑफ साउथ ईस्ट एशियन नेशंस. ओके एंड डू यू गाइज नो वॉट इट डज, लाइक वॉट डू यू मीन बाय एसोसिएशन ऑफ साउथ ईस्ट एशियन नेशंस? Basically, students, it facilitates economical, political, security, military, educational, and socio-cultural integration among the Asian countries. Okay, so let's see the next question. Where was the India Association of Southeast Asian Nations Troika Trade Ministers Meeting held? मतलब यहाँ पे हमें मीटिंग कहाँ पे हुई थी, उनकी ASEAN जिसका हमने अभी जस्ट फुल फॉर्म देखा, उनकी मीटिंग कहाँ पे हुई गई थी ऐसे पूछा है. मुंबई, न्यू दिल्ली, कोलकाता, चेन्नई. सो व्हाट डू यू गाइस थिंक? सो द राइट आंसर इज न्यू दिल्ली. ओके न्यू दिल्ली में जुलाई 9 को 2019 को ASEAN की मीटिंग हुई थी. Here is the next question. Dash edition of India-Russia Strategic Economic Dialogue 2019 held in New Delhi recently. So, second edition was actually held in New Delhi. Okay, so the right answer is second. That is third. Second edition of India-Russia Strategic Economic Dialogue 2019 was held in New Delhi recently. Okay and basically this edition, it aims at bilateral cooperation between two countries in various fields. Okay, do you know what is bilateral cooperation? Bilateral cooperation means the cooperation activities directly between one developed country in a developing country. Okay, like it is there in Portuguese to East Timor. Okay, so the second edition was held in New Delhi. Okay, so let's see the next question. who has chaired the second India-Russia Strategic Economic Dialogue IRSED 2019 from Indian side. मतलब जो सेकेंड एडिशन था जो हमने लास्ट क्वेश्चन में देखा वो सेकेंड एडिशन IRSED का इंडिया के साइड से किसने लीड किया था ऐसे पूछा है एंड द गिवन ऑप्शंस आर नीरा बेदी शिवम तीता नृपेंद्र मिश्रा राजीव कुमार एंड नन ऑफ दीज सो द राइट आंसर इज राजीव कुमार राजीव कुमार ने IRSED की जो सेकेंड एडिशन हुआ था उसे इंडियन साइड से लीड किया था डू यू नो हु इज राजीव कुमार राजीव कुमार ही इज़ द वाइस चेयरमैन ऑफ इंडियाज थिंक टैंक दैट इज NITI आयोग NITI आयोग वॉट इज NITI बेसिकली दे कैन आस्क लाइक एग्जाम में ऐसा भी क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं वॉट इज़ द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ NITI सो NITI का फुल फॉर्म है नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग इंडिया ओके नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग इंडिया ओके सो राजीव कुमार हु इज ही इज द वाइस चेयरमैन ऑफ इंडियाज थिंक टैंक नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ फॉर ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग इंडिया NITI आयोग ओके सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच फिल्म्स रेयर फुटेज वॉज एक्वायर्ड बाय नेशनल फिल्म अचीव ऑफ इंडिया NFAI रिसेंटली सो नेशनल फिल्म अचीव ऑफ इंडिया NFAI ने कौन सी फिल्म की रेयर फुटेज ऑप्टेन की गई थी ऐसे पूछा है सो 1971 वंदे मातरम हिंदुस्तान की कसम परमवीर चक्र और नन ऑफ दीज सो द राइट आंसर ऑफ दिस इज वंदे मातरम ओके दिस नेशनल फिल्म अचीव ऑफ इंडिया NFAI इट इज़ बेसिकली पुणे बेस्ड एसोसिएशन ओके इट इज़ अ पुणे बेस्ड एसोसिएशन और इन्होंने वंदे मातरम फिल्म की जो फुटेज थी वो ली थी एंड दिस वंदे मातरम मूवी इस मूवी के जो राइटर है ही इज़ द फेमस राइटर एंड प्ले राइटर बेसिकली हिज नेम इज़ मिस्टर PL देशपांडे He with his wife Sunita Deshpande, they basically played the major role, okay, major role in this film and in this rare footage, okay. So let's see the next question. Vande Mataram film was acquired by National Film Archive of India (NFAI). Yes, we saw it in last question, but here they have asked कि वो कौन सी language में release की गई थी. ओके सो बंगाली तेलुगु मराठी हिंदी नन ऑफ दीज व्हाट डू यू थिंक इनमें से कौन सा ऑप्शन होगा कौन से लैंग्वेज में वो मूवी रिलीज की गई थी सो इफ यू गाइज नो PL देशपांडे ही इज फेमस फॉर हिज मराठी राइटिंग्स ओके सो ये जो वंदे मातरम फिल्म थी इट वाज आल्सो रिलीज्ड इन मराठी लैंग्वेज ओके And it was directed by, मतलब ये जो वंदे मातरम फिल्म थी it was directed by a film maker. His name is Ram Gabale. Okay. So let's move towards the further questions. Name the scheme launched by Ministry of Women and Child Development, WCD, for the rehabilitation of women in different circumstances. यहाँ पे पूछा है कि एक स्कीम लॉन्च की गई थी मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट ने तो वो कौन सी स्कीम है ऐसे पूछा है मतलब डिफरेंट डिफ़िकल्ट सर्कमस्टांसेस, मुश्किल हालातों से लेके उनको नॉर्मल लाइफ में ट्रेनिंग दे के अच्छी हेल्थ में रिस्टोर करने के लिए ये स्कीम लॉन्च की गई थी. ओके, फॉर वुमेन. ओके, सो वो स्कीम का नाम क्या था ऐसे पूछा है. सो साबला राष्ट्रीय महिला कोष, स्वाधर गृह स्कीम, प्रधानमंत्री मातृत्व वंदना योजना. सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक इसका आंसर क्या होगा? सो द राइट आंसर ऑफ दिस इज स्वाधर गृह स्कीम. ओके, ये स्कीम लॉन्च की गई थी बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट फॉर रिहैबिलिटेशन ऑफ वुमेन इन डिफरेंट डिफिकल्ट सर्कमस्टांसेस. ओके, सो हियर इज द नेक्स्ट वन. हु लॉन्च द फेज टू ऑफ डायरेक्ट बेनिफिट ट्रांसफर DBT ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर सब्सिडी इन न्यू दिल्ली? DV सांदना गोवडा, नरेंद्र मोदी, अमित शाह, निर्मला सीतारामन. व्हाट डू यू थिंक? DBT का फेज टू किसने लॉन्च किया था? सो DV गोवडा, इन्होंने DBT का फेज टू लॉन्च किया था फर्टिलाइजर सब्सिडी का. ओके, डू यू गाइज नो हु इज सदानंद गोवडा? सदानंद गोवडा बेसिकली ही इज द यूनियन मिनिस्टर फॉर केमिकल्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स. ओके, सदानंद गोवडा ही इज द यूनियन मिनिस्टर फॉर केमिकल्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स. ओके, नरेंद्र मोदी ये तो आपको पता होगा, ही इज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. हु इज अमित शाह? अमित शाह इज द करंट मिनिस्टर ऑफ होम अफेयर्स. ओके, एंड हु इज निर्मला सीतारामन? शी इज द फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर एंड इवन द मिनिस्टर ऑफ कॉरपोरेट अफेयर्स. ओके, सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट वन. इन ऑर्डर टू बूस्ट विच मिशन, एन MOU वॉज साइंड बिटवीन द इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी फैसिलिटेशन सेल IPFC, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ डिफेंस प्रोडक्शन, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ डिफेंस एंड नेशनल रिसर्च डेवलपमेंट कोऑपरेशन NRDC, एंड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. ओके, सो इतने सारे इन सब डिपार्टमेंट्स के बीच में एक MOU साइन हुआ था टू बूस्ट विच मिशन. एंड यहाँ पे अलग अलग मिशन्स के नाम दिए गए, मिशन सुकून, मिशन रिस्टोर होप, मिशन संकट मोचन, मिशन रक्षा ज्ञान शक्ति एंड नन ऑफ दीज. सो डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री ने इस मिशन को बूस्ट करने के लिए बेसिकली ये मिशन लॉन्च किया था. ओके, और उसके लिए इतने सारे डिपार्टमेंट्स के बीच में MOU साइन हुआ था. सो जो जो मिशन मिशन लॉन्च किया गया था उसका नाम था मिशन रक्षा ज्ञान शक्ति. ओके, सो दिस इज द राइट आंसर, मिशन रक्षा ज्ञान शक्ति. एंड बेसिकली IPFC डिफेंस प्रोडक्शन, देन NRDC एंड साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी के मिनिस्ट्री, इन सब के बीच में MOU साइन हुआ था फॉर दिस मिशन. ओके, डू यू नो द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ MOU? इन बेसिकली इन माई प्रीवियस सेशन आई कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट वेरियस MOU साइंड बिटवीन यूनियन कैबिनेट्स एंड वेरियस यू नो मिनिस्ट्रीज. ओके, सो आई होप यू हैव सीन दैट वीडियो ऑल्सो, बट स्टिल आई विल टेल यू द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ MOU. MOU का फुल फॉर्म है मेमोरेंडम ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके, मेमोरेंडम ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके, दिस इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ MOU. दिस इज वेरी बेसिक थिंग, यू शुड नो दिस थिंग. ओके, लेट्स मूव टूवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट. नेम द ऑपरेशन लॉन्च्ड बाय रेलवे प्रोटेक्शन फोर्स RPF इन न्यू दिल्ली टू क्रैक डाउन the selling of unauthorized packaged drinking water PDW in the premises of railway stations. So यहाँ पे पूछा है कि रेलवे स्टेशन पे जो अनऑथोराइज्ड पैकेज ड्रिंकिंग वाटर होता है दैट इज PDW, उसको क्रैक डाउन करने के लिए, बेसिकली उसको पहचानने के लिए एक ऑपरेशन लॉन्च किया गया था. उस ऑपरेशन का नाम क्या है? ऑपरेशन पानी, थर्स्ट, एक्वा, वाटर. सो टू कन्फ्यूज बेसिकली उन्होंने अलग अलग नाम दिए हैं वाटर के. सो द मेन ऑपरेशन विच वॉज लॉन्च्ड by RPF, that is Railway Protection Force, is Operation Thirst. Okay, so they can ask this question also, like what is the full form of RPF. It is very basic, but still you should know. RPF ko full form is Railway Protection Force, and even PDW, Packaged Drinking Water. Okay, even sometimes we get confused for these basic things also. So just make sure that you are taking notes of these full forms. These are very basic things which we use in day-to-day life. Okay, so RPF ne Operation Thirst ye operation launch kiya tha to crack down unauthorized packaged drinking waters. Okay, so here is the next one. Where was the fifth edition of India-EU high-level dialogue on migration and mobility held recently? So, New Delhi, India. New Delhi mein India-EU ki high-level dialogue meeting, fifth edition meeting was held, okay, on migration and mobility. Basically, to move freely from one place to another is migration and mobility, okay, and India-EU matlab India and European Union, okay. Indian and European Union के बीच में ये fifth edition हुई थी. It was in New Delhi, okay. For what? For migration and mobility, okay. So let's see the next one. Name the article that provides special status to Jammu and Kashmir, which is temporary provision in part XX1. Temporary, transitional and special provisions of constitution. Oh, so we all know that the recent article came. What was it? Which was that? It was article 370 on JNK, Jammu and Kashmir. Okay. And basically it was, it was stated by Union Minister of State for Home Affairs, that is G. Krishan Reddy. Okay, G. Kishan Reddy. Who is he? He is Union Minister of State for Home Affairs. Union Minister of State for Home Affairs. Okay. So basically article 370 ये article आया था. It was in news for like so many days. So सबको इस question का जवाब तो पता ही है. Okay, फिर भी I hope that you have read the full article 370 on demand. If you want, we can also make a video on article 370. Like this is the current topic and it is expected that many questions can be asked on this. Okay, so just make sure that you are going thorough on this. Okay, so let's see the next one. Which state was ranked as the best among states and union territories UTs in the field of education as per the performance grading index 2017 and 18? So as far as the education is concerned, यहाँ पे पूछा गया है कि UTs मतलब states and united union territories के हिसाब से कौन सी state was ranked on best, मतलब basically कौन सी state first rank पे थी. Okay, so the given options are Chandigarh, Kerala, Gujarat, Haryana and none of these. So the right answer of this is Chandigarh. Okay, and ये जो रैंक है ये किसने इन्फॉर्म की गई थी की थी बेसिकली दिस रैंक वॉज इन्फॉर्म बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स एंड डेवलपमेंट दैट इज एच RD, okay, Ministry of Human Resources and Development, they informed this performance grading index, okay, of Chandigarh. Okay, so the right answer of this is Chandigarh was ranked as best among states and union territories in field of education. Okay, so here is the next one. Name the state which has the highest literacy rate as per the performance grading index. Okay, so कौन सी स्टेट में हाईएस्ट लिटरेसी रेट है ऐसा पूछा है. लक्षद्वीप, मिजोरम, अरुणाचल प्रदेश, केरला और नॉन ऑफ दीज. इफ यू गाइज नो, केरला इज वन ऑफ दो स्टेट्स विच इज हाईली लिटरेट. ओके, सो एज पर द परफॉर्मेंस ग्रेडिंग इंडेक्स इज कंसर्न, हियर ऑल्सो केरला इज द हाईएस्ट लिटरेसी रेट. ओके, and after Kerala, Lakshadweep comes thus on the second rank and Mizoram comes on the third one. Okay, so Kerala, it is the highest literacy rate, it has the highest literacy rate, followed by Lakshadweep and Mizoram. Okay, so remember this also. So let's see the next one. Name the South Korean multinational automotive manufacturer which plans to launch its electric car for India. Okay, so as we all know ki petrol diesel to abhi band hone wala hai, electric cars aane wali hai. So kaun si South Korean multinational automotive manufacturer hai jo electric car ko India mein launch kar rahi hai. Okay, so Kia Motors, Hyundai, Renault, Samsung Motors, Divu or none of these. What is the answer? Hyundai. Okay, so Hyundai is basically going to launch the electric car in India. Okay, and it is the South Korean multinational automotive manufacturer. Okay, many of you almost पता नहीं होगा कि ज़्यादा लोगों को कि Hyundai is a South Korean multinational automotive manufacturer. Okay, सो अभी पता चल गया है. ओके, बेसिकली मिनिस्टर फॉर इंडस्ट्रीज MC Sampath. ओके, MC Sampath, ही स्टेटेड दैट Hyundai इज प्लानिंग टू लॉन्च इलेक्ट्रिक कार इन इंडिया. ओके, हु स्टेटेड? MC Sampath. MC Sampath, ही इज द मिनिस्टर फॉर इंडस्ट्रीज. ओके, so let's see the next one. Which is the first state in India to manufacture electric cars? कौन सी स्टेट है जो इलेक्ट्रिक कार्स को सबसे पहले इंडिया में मैन्युफैक्चर करेगी? उत्तर प्रदेश, गुजरात, तमिलनाडु, महाराष्ट्र, नन ऑफ दीज. सो द राइट आंसर इज तमिलनाडु. ओके, and basically global market from Chennai facility, they are going to help Tamil Nadu to be the first state in India to manufacture electric cars. Okay, global market from Chennai facility. So here is the next one. Name the organization which launched an initiative in the form of a unique document identification number UDIN to improve corporate governance. कौन सी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऐसी है जिसने UDIN को बेसिकली फॉर्म किया था कॉर्पोरेट गवर्नेंस को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए? वो एक इनिशिएटिव लॉन्च किया था इस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने. ओके, सो वो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का नाम क्या ऐसे पूछा है? सो ICSI, ICAI, IICA, ICWAI, अलग अलग बहुत ऑप्शंस दिए गए टू कंफ्यूज. ओके, सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक? कंपनी सेक्रेटरीज, चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स, कॉर्पोरेट अफेयर्स और कॉस्ट एंड वर्क्स अकाउंटेंट्स. सो द राइट आंसर इज कंपनी सेक्रेटरीज ऑफ इंडिया, इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ कंपनी सेक्रेटरीज ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, बेसिकली दे लॉन्च्ड एन इनिशिएटिव टू फॉर्म यूनिक डॉक्यूमेंट आइडेंटिफिकेशन नंबर, दैट इज UDIN. even in exams they can ask this also, what is the full form of UDIN? So the full form of UDIN is Unique Document Identification Number. Okay, and the answer of this question is Institute of Company Secretaries of India, that is ICSI. Okay, so the president of this ICSI, that is Institute of Company Secretaries, is Ranjit Kumar Pandey. Okay, he is also a company secretary. So the president of this ICSI is Ranjit Kumar Pandey. Okay, so here is the next one. Name the campaign launched by Maritime Anti-Corruption Network, that is MACN, to tackle corruption in the maritime industry in India. Okay, do you know what is maritime industry? Basically, maritime industry, it includes naval architecture and marine and ocean engineering. Okay, these are basically the fast growing and dynamic fields. ओके सो यहाँ पे पूछा गया है कि MACN, दैट इज मैरीटाइम एंटी करप्शन नेटवर्क, ने एक कैंपेन लॉन्च की गई थी टू टैकल द करप्शन ओके इन दिस इंडस्ट्री. सो व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस कैंपेन? एंटी करप्शन नेटवर्क कैंपेन, एंटी करप्शन कैंपेन, मैरीटाइम कैंपेन, पोस्ट इंटीग्रिटी कैंपेन. सो द राइट आंसर इज सॉरी पोस्ट नॉट पोस्ट इट इज पोर्ट. सो द राइट आंसर इज Port, okay, that is Port Integrity Campaign. So here is the next question. In which state the dedicated universities for conducting courses in police services and internal security was set up? Matlab police services and internal security के जो कोर्सेज है वो कंडक्ट करने के लिए यूनिवर्सिटी सेटअप की गई थी. सो वो कौन सी स्टेट में सेट की गई थी ऐसे पूछा है. सो राजस्थान, गुजरात, झारखंड या फिर ऑल ऑफ द अबाव. सो द राइट आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑल ऑफ द अबाव, विच मीन्स राजस्थान, गुजरात, झारखंड. इन ऑल दीज स्टेट्स दिस डेडिकेटेड यूनिवर्सिटीज वर सेटअप. ओके, बेसिकली मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर होम अफेयर्स जी किशन रेड्डी, जो हमने जस्ट अभी एक दो क्वेश्चंस पीछे ही मैंने आपको बताया था, ही बेसिकली ही स्टेटेड दिस सेटअप. ओके, दिस सेटअप फॉर कंडक्टिंग कोर्सेज इन पुलिस सर्विसेज. ओके, जी किशन रेड्डी, जी किशन रेड्डी. सो हु इज जी किशन रेड्डी? He is Minister of State for Home Affairs. Okay, so let's see the next one. What was the new national level sex ratio at birth SRB for the time period between FY, that is financial year 2015-16 and 2018-19, as per the Ministry of Women and Child Development, that is WCD. Okay, so यहाँ पे हम लोगों को उन्होंने न्यू सेक्स रेशियो एट बर्थ दैट इज SRB ये पूछा है. ओके, फॉर दिस ईयर फाइनेंशियल ईयर 15-16 एंड 18-19. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द न्यू SRB? सो इट इज 931. ओके, सो बेसिकली इन दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2015-16 एंड 18-19 द SRB, दैट इज सेक्स रेशियो एट बर्थ, वॉज इनक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम 923 to 931. ओके, सो हियर इज द नेक्स्ट वन. वेयर वॉज द 11th मेकोंग गंगा कोऑपरेशन सीनियर ऑफिशियल्स मीटिंग MGCSOM 2019 held? ओके, सो दिस वेरी लॉन्ग नेम ऑफ मीटिंग, ये मीटिंग कहाँ हेल्ड की गई थी ऐसे पूछा है. ओके, सो द राइट आंसर इज न्यू दिल्ली, इंडिया. ओके ओके, डू यू नो दिस मीटिंग, वाई दिस मीटिंग वॉज हेल्ड? This meeting was held basically to review the progress in several areas of cooperation. Okay, and it was held on 9 July. July 9, 2019. Basically, see students, whatever questions I'm going to cover are basically belong for the month July, okay, and 2019. So whatever the date may be, but the month will be July only, okay. So this meeting was held in New Delhi, India. So next question they have given is expand QIPS. Okay, QIPS ka full form poocha hai yahan pe. And they have given us various options. So what do you think? QIPS, they have just, you know, interchanged the names to confuse. QIPS. So what QIPS stands for? Basically, QIPS stands for Quick Impact Project Scheme. Okay, so the right option is this fourth, Quick Impact Project Scheme. So let's move towards the further questions. Which state will host the Women's Startup Summit 2019 with the theme Developing an Inclusive Entrepreneurship Ecosystem? Okay, so Women's Startup Summit 2019, this is the event. Who will host, which state will host this event, aise poocha gaya hai. Okay, and this event will have the theme of developing an inclusive entrepreneurship ecosystem. Okay, so Kolkata, West Bengal, then New Delhi, then Kochi, then Mumbai, and none of these. So the right answer of this question is Kochi, Kerala. Okay. Basically, this Women's Startup 2019, this summit, it is a summit, and basically it aims to encourage aspiring women professionals to take up their entrepreneurial journey and develop the entrepreneurship ecosystem. Okay. So it will be hosted. It will be hosted by the state, Kochi in Kerala. Okay, so let's see the next one. Name the initiative launched by the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare to improve quality of care in labor room and maternity operation theatres in public health facilities. So, kaun sa initiative launch kiya gaya tha by Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare? Aise poocha gaya. Basically, to improve the quality in maternity operation and labor room. So they have given us different options. So the initiative launched by our government of India to improve the quality of care in labor room and maternity operation is Lakshya. Okay. LAQSHYA Lakshya, Labor Room Quality Improvement Initiative. Remember this full form also, Labor Room Quality Improvement Initiative, that is Lakshya. Okay, and it was launched by whom? Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Okay, so here is the next question. Which has become the first state in India to ensure water conservation with its state water policy? Okay, so which state has become the first one in India? Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Assam, or none of these? What do you think? So Meghalaya was the first state in India to ensure water conservation with its state water policy. Okay, basically it was approved, this state water policy was approved by state cabinet. Okay, and this state cabinet approved this this policy in a meeting chaired by Meghalaya Chief Minister. Who is the Chief Minister of Meghalaya? Conrad K. Sangma. Okay. Who is the Chief Minister of Meghalaya? Conrad K. Sangma. I know the name is little difficult, but still you have to remember this. He is the Chief Minister of Meghalaya. Okay. Basically, do you know why this policy has come? Like this policy, basically it aims to recognize water resources as a common pool resource, okay, and to provide basically safe and hygienic water for drinking, for domestic sanitation and livelihood development, okay. So Meghalaya has become the first one in India, okay. So let's move towards the further questions. Who released the report titled National Digital Health Blueprint, which proposes to form a national digital health mission? Rajkumar Singh, Jitendra Singh, Kiran Rijiju, Dr. Harshvardhan, and none of these. So, National Digital Health Blueprint इस रिपोर्ट को किसने रिलीज किया था ऐसे पूछा गया है. एंड दिस रिपोर्ट वॉज रिलीज्ड टू फॉर्म अ नेशनल डिजिटल हेल्थ मिशन. ओके, सो हु रिलीज दिस रिपोर्ट? डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन रिलीज दिस रिपोर्ट. ओके, एंड बेसिकली फॉर रिलीजिंग दिस रिपोर्ट एंड टू यू नो मेक दिस रिपोर्ट टाइटल्ड नेशनल डिजिटल हेल्थ ब्लू प्रिंट, अ हाई लेवल कमिटी वॉज सेट अप बाय यूनियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. ओके, सो दे कैन आस्क इन दिस वे ऑल्सो, लाइक हु सेट अप द नेशनल डिजिटल हेल्थ ब्लू प्रिंट रिपोर्ट. ओके, सो द आंसर विल बी यूनियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर. ओके, एंड डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन ही इज ऑल्सो द हेल्थ मिनिस्टर. ओके, सो रिमेंबर द हेल्थ मिनिस्टर्स नेम, दैट इज डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन. ओके, सो लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. GSTN इज इन न्यूज रिसेंटली, व्हाट डज एन स्टैंड फॉर? ओके, वी हैव सीन मेनी न्यूज लाइक GSTN, विच इंक्लूड्स GSTN, राइट? सो व्हाट डज दिस एन मीन्स? नॉर्मेटिव, नेटवर्क, नेट न्यूट्रलिटी और नन ऑफ दीज. सो द राइट राइट फुल फॉर्म ऑफ दिस एन इज नेटवर्क. ओके, GST नेटवर्क. द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ GSTN इज गुड्स एंड सर्विस टैक्स नेटवर्क. ओके, गुड्स एंड सर्विस टैक्स नेटवर्क. ओके, सो लेट्स मूव टुवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट वन. विच इंस्टीट्यूट हैज कोलैबोरेटेड विद द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ टू लीड द लार्जेस्ट पैन इंडिया ओरल हेल्थ सर्वे 2019? मतलब यहाँ पे पूछा गया है कि कौन सी इंस्टीट्यूट ने मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ के साथ कोलैबोरेट किया था टू लीड लार्जेस्ट पैन इंडिया, ओके, इन ओरल हेल्थ सर्वे. सो दे हैव गिवन अस वेरियस इंस्टीट्यूट्स इन ऑप्शंस, बट द राइट इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर विच कोलैबोरेटेड विद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ इज ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेस. ओके, मेडिकल साइंसेस हैज कोलैबोरेटेड विद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ, दैट इज AIIMS, सेंटर फॉर डेंटल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च, CDER. नोट डाउन दिस फुल फॉर्म ऑल्सो, ऑल इंडिया इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेज, दैट इज AIIMS, सेंटर फॉर डेंटल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च, दैट इज CDER. ओके, सो दिस इंस्टीट्यूट कोलैबोरेटेड विद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ टू लीड द लार्जेस्ट पैन इंडिया ओरल हेल्थ सर्वे 2019. ओके, सो Which department has signed MOU with Indian Council for Research on International Economic Relations, that is ICRIER, to develop a broadband readiness index, BRI, that is broadband readiness index, that is BRI. So students, on 16 July 2019, Department of Telecom, here you can see this option 3, Department of Telecommunication, Department of Telecom, and Indian Council for Research on International Economic Relations, that is ICRIER, they signed this MOU. Okay, they both signed MOU, DOT and ICRIER, they signed MOU to develop broadband readiness index. Okay, do you know what is broadband readiness index, BRI? So BRI, basically it is a technology readiness, it can be called as technology readiness also, and it measures propensity for countries to exploit the opportunities offered by ICT. ICT, what is ICT? Information, communication and technology. Okay, and basically this BRI, it is published in collaboration with INSEAD. Do you know what is full form of INSEAD? Do you know what is INSEAD? INSEAD, it is a graduate business school which has campus in Europe, in Singapore, in Abu Dhabi basically. Okay, so this is what BRI means. Okay, it is a technology readiness also. It referred as a technology readiness also. Okay, which is completely offering opportunities in ICT, that is information, communication and technology. So here is the next one. ISPAI was in news recently. What does S stands for? So they have asked, they haven't asked us the full form, but they have asked the what S stands for. So the full form of ISPAI is Internet Service Providers Association of India, that is Internet Service Providers Association of India. Okay, this is the full form of ISPAI. Okay, so what S stands for? It stands for service. Okay, basically, do you know why ISPAI was launched? Basically, this Association of India, this ISPAI, it was set up in 1998. They had a mission, basically, of a tagline, promote internet for benefit of all. Okay, promote internet for the benefit of all. And basically, it is launched to promote internet or broadband for all. Okay, so remember the full form of ISPAI, and when it was launched in 1998, and the full form is Internet Service Providers Association of India. Okay, so here is the next question. Who has been unanonymously elected as members of Public Accounts Committee, PAC, from Lok Sabha? Okay, matlab Lok Sabha se PAC, like member of PAC, that is Public Accounts Committee, ke liye unanimously basically कौन elect किया गया था ऐसे पूछा है. Okay, so they have given us different names. So the right name, the right people who were chosen were Adhir Rajan Chaudhary, Satyapal Singh and Jayant Sinha. Okay. Who is Adhir Rajan Chaudhary? He is one of the Congress leaders. Okay. And who is Satyapal Singh? He is former Minister of State for Human Resource Development, that is HRD. He is a former minister. Okay. And who is Jayant Sinha? He is also a former Minister of State for Civil Aviation. Okay, so remember, they both are the former ministers, but for what? He is for Civil Aviation and he is for HRD, that is Human Resource Development. Okay, and he is one of the Congress leaders. Okay, so let's see the next question. PMSYM scheme was in news recently. What does S stand for? Okay, so what does S stand for? S stands for SRAM. That is the right option is 2. S is for SRAM. And what is the full form of this PMSYM? Pradhan Mantri SRAM Yogi Mandhan. Okay. Pradhan Mantri SRAM Yogi Man Dhan. Okay, this is the full form of PMSYM and S stands for SRAM. Okay, basically this scheme it was introduced by Government of India for poor laborers. Okay, and it will, you know, under this scheme, the monthly pension of 3000 rupees will be provided to workers who are over 60 years of age. Okay, and this was launched by Government of India. Okay, it was a scheme launched in 2019. Okay, so PMSYM, the full form is Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan. Okay, so let's see the next question. Name the pension scheme under which 30,85,205 persons have enrolled till July 10, 2019. Okay, यहाँ पे एक pension scheme का नाम पूछा है जिसके under इतने सारे लोगों ने 10 जुलाई तक enroll किया था, almost 40 lakh people. So the pension scheme, the name of this pension scheme is Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan. Abhi just hum logon ne dekha, it was this scheme was launched for laborers and it will give pension for monthly rupees 3000. Okay, so basically Shri Santosh Kumar Gangwar, he is the Union Minister of State for Labor and Employment. He stated this pension scheme. Okay, so who stated this pension scheme? Santosh Kumar Gangwar. Santosh Kumar Gangwar. Who is he? He is the Union Minister of State for Labor and Employment. Okay, so let's see the next one. How much amount is given as monthly pension to the beneficiaries of attaining the age of 60 years under Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Yojana? Kitni amount di gayi hai monthly pension mein, aise pucha gaya. I just gave you the information about this. So the right answer, what is the right answer? Rupees 3000 per month. Okay, and remember the age year also, above 60 years. Okay. Which state is set to host the first ever Himalayan States Conclave on 28 July 2019? Himalayan States Conclave kaun si state mein host kiya jayega, aise pucha hai. So Uttarakhand is the state jahan par Himalayan States Conclave will be hosting. Okay, and it will be hosted on July 28, okay, in Uttarakhand. In more detail, it will be held in Mussoorie, that is Mussoorie in Uttarakhand. Okay, and the main focus of this conclave will be to sustain to make sustainable development in of Indian Himalayan region. Okay, like this Uttarakhand, Mussoorie, etc., etc. Right? Okay. So let's see the next question. Golden Jubilee Edition 2019 50th edition of International Film Festival of India, IFFI, to be celebrated in which state? So Golden Jubilee IFFI ki, International Film Festival of India ki Golden Jubilee, that is 50th edition, kaun se state mein celebrate ki jayegi, aise pucha hai. And it will be celebrated in Goa, Panji. Okay, Minister of Information and Broadcasting. Who is Minister of Information and Broadcasting? Mr. Prakash Javedkar. Okay, Mr. Prakash Javedkar. He stated this this International Film Festival of India, India's Golden Jubilee will be celebrated in Goa. Okay, and just for the information, let me tell you, Russia will be the international partner for this 2019 edition of IFFI, and this Golden Jubilee celebration will be edition will be scheduled from 28th to 28th November 2019. Okay, so here is the next one. Which ministry has launched Kaushal Yuva Samvad, a youth dialogue, to celebrate the 4th anniversary of the Skill India mission? Kaushal Yuva Samvad, it is a youth dialogue, and to celebrate the 4th anniversary of Skill India mission, कौन सी मिनिस्ट्री ने दिस ये लॉन्च किया था? मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पर्सनल पब्लिक ग्रीवेंसेस एंड पेंशंस, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कम्युनिकेशंस एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. विच मिनिस्ट्री हैज लॉन्च्ड दिस दिस यूथ डायलॉग? So, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, MOSDE, they launched this youth dialogue, that is Kaushal Yuva Samvad, on July 15. On July 15. Okay. And where it was launched? It was launched in New Delhi. Okay. So basically this this, you know, this mission, this dialogue, this everything, it was aimed at creating an open dialogue with youth across all skill training centers to hear their views, their ideas, their opportunities and recommendations, to help Ministry of Skill Development, you know, to scale up the existing programs and improve the efficiency of ongoing projects, to improve basically every the existing programs which are there for the students, the youth of this country, to improve all those things. This Kaushal Yuva Samvad was launched. Okay, so let's see the next question. How many gram panchayats were linked with optical fiber under BharatNet program? मतलब कितनी ग्राम पंचायत लिंक की गई है ऑप्टिकल फाइबर से अंडर BharatNet program? BharatNet program के अंडर. So how many gram panchayats? About 1.28 lakh gram panchayats. They are basically linked with optical fiber. Okay, And basically on July 16, the Union Panchayat Raj Minister Narendra Singh Tomar, he informed this information, okay, who stated, Union Panchayat Raj Minister, that is Narendra Singh Tomar, he is the Union Panchayat Raj Minister, and he stated this, he gave this information of 1.28 lakh gram panchayats are linked with optical fiber under BharatNet program. Okay, so which two countries hold the meetings in New Delhi to boost the bilateral cooperation to the next level in the field of space, including assistance in India's Maidan human space flight mission Gaganyaan? So which two countries hold these meetings? India, Germany, India, China, India, Russia, or India, Japan, or none of these? So basically, to boost the bilateral cooperation to next level, India and Russia, these two countries hold the meetings in New Delhi. Okay, basically to gain the next level in the field of space, these meetings were held. So the right answer is India and Russia. India and Russia are the two countries which hold the meetings in New Delhi. Okay, to take the field of space in next level. Okay, so to protect which two Indian birds, Supreme Court SC has constituted a high-powered committee to urgently frame and implement an emergency response plan. So yahan pe pucha gaya hai ki to protect which two Indian birds, Supreme Court has constituted a high-powered committee. Okay, so which two Indian birds? Name itself says, it's Great Indian Bustard and Lesser Florican. Okay, so these are the two species of Indian birds for whom Supreme Court has constituted a high-powered committee. Okay, so let's see the next question. Where the government of India has decided to build India-based neutrino observatory, INO. Okay, so yahan pe pucha gaya hai ki government of India ne INO build karne ka decide kiya hai. Okay, what is INO? India-based neutrino observatory. So where Pithampur, Dispur, Masuri, Pottipuram, and iske alawa aur bhi bahut sare, like is ek hi option mein alag alag jagah ke naam diye. So what is the answer? It is in Pottipuram, Theni district, Tamil Nadu. Okay, where does the Pottipuram belong? It belongs from Tamil Nadu. Okay, and even they can ask this, what is the full form of INO? So INO ka full form is India based neutrino observatory. Okay, and basically Union Minister of State Development of Northern Eastern Region and MOS Minister of Union Minister of State Prime Minister's Office, basically they all came to the conclusion that they are going to build this India based neutrino observatory in Pottipuram, Theni district, Tamil Nadu. Okay, so here is the next one. Which states 2880 MW Dibang multipurpose project was approved by cabinet recently for the amount of ₹1600 crore. So there's this project name 2880 MW Dibang multipurpose project. It was approved by cabinet for amount 1600 crore. So which state's project is this? उन्होंने ऐसा पूछा है. So this project belongs to the state Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. So the right option is 1, that is Arunachal Pradesh. So here is the next question. Name the commission whose term was extended by cabinet up to November 30, 2019. So they have asked us the name of the commission. Okay, whose term was extended by cabinet up to 30 November 2019. So which commission? 15th Finance, National Statistical, National Commission for Women, Space Commission, or none of these. So the right answer is 15th Finance Commission. 15th Finance Commission, its term was extended by cabinet up to 30. And basically this 15th Finance Commission, it was constituted by the President of India, in November 27, 2017. Okay, so this commission was actually constituted by the President of India on November 27, 2017. Okay, under Article 280. Okay. So let's see the next and the last question of the session. Which railway line has received cabinet approval for construction via Rangia doubling 142.97 km of Northeast Frontier Railway in Assam with an estimated cost of ₹2042.51 crore? ओके, सो कौन सी रेलवे को कैबिनेट का अप्रूवल मिला था फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन वाया दिस रंगिया डबलिंग ऑफ बेसिकली रंगिया डबलिंग इट बिलोंग्स टू आसाम. ओके, एंड इट बिलोंग्स टू नॉर्थ ईस्ट फ्रंटियर रेलवे इन आसाम. ओके, सो एंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ दिस कंस्ट्रक्शन वॉज 2042.51 crore. So, कौन सी कैबिनेट ने अप्रूवल दिया था, कौन से रेलवे लाइन के लिए कैबिनेट को अप्रूवल मिला था, ऐसे यहाँ पे पूछा गया. विच रेलवे लाइन हैज रिसीव द कैबिनेट अप्रूवल. ओके, सो द रेलवे लाइन इज विच वन? न्यू बोंगाईगांव एंड अगथोरी. ओके, न्यू बोंगाईगांव एंड अगथोरी, दीज आर द रेलवे लाइन्स दैट रिसीव्ड कैबिनेट अप्रूवल फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन. ओके, एंड इट इज एस्टिमेटेड दैट दिस प्रोजेक्ट विल बी कंप्लीटेड बाय 2022-23. So students, this was all for today. I hope you have taken the notes and will work hard for the exams. These questions are very important as far as your exams are concerned. And if you want to see more questions and have liked our session, subscribe our channel, and yes, don't forget to click on the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching.